Now let us discuss about the power system transient. Also we have discussed what is power system transient, what are the causes of power system transient, what is voltage surge, what is transient voltage, what is the nature of voltage transient, and all other definitions. Now it can be classified into 2 to 3 parts. One is ultra fast transient. So as already we have discussed that the time period of the transient is few microseconds to milliseconds. Okay, so ultra fast transient is in the category of microseconds, medium fast transient is in the category of milliseconds, and the slow transient it's also around the in the category of milliseconds also. Okay, so as far as ultra fast transient is concerned, the example of ultra fast transient is nothing but lightning or the regular switching operation. As far as medium fast transient is concerned, so short circuit in the power system, and slow transient is nothing but the rotor oscillation in synchronous machine. All these things we'll cover in the further part. Okay, so as far as causes of the transient is concerned, it can be occurred in a power system due to some external causes. Also it can be due to some internal causes. As far as external causes is concerned, the one will be lightning stroke. Okay, and as far as internal transient is concerned, which is switching surges, arcing ground, and the resonance in a power system. Okay, all these things now we are going to discuss in next section. Okay, so over voltage due to external causes. So the cause of over voltage external is the lightning in the sky, and moreover it is happens generally in a monsoon condition. So how the lightning is produced? So during the monsoon, due to the thunderstorm caused due to some atmospheric process, electrical charge get accumulated in clouds. Okay, it can be positive charges or it can be a negative charges. When this cloud pass over a ground, it include charge of opposite polarity. Now assume there is a cloud right here, and due to the thunderstorm and the atmospheric condition, the charge contains in this cloud is negative. Okay, now when this cloud pass over the ground, it induced charge of opposite polarity. Now obviously this cloud has negative charge cloud, so negatively charged. So when it is passed from the ground, it obviously induced opposite polarity charge, which is positive. So now earth is positively charged with respect to that cloud. Okay, so the next, as charge on the cloud increases, the potential between cloud and earth also increases. So this is very straightforward. When the charge increases, so the potential between the cloud and earth is also going to be increases. Now when potential become very high, let's say in the range of 5 to 20 million volts, the air between the both cloud and the earth will break down at some point, and at that time the lightning flash will take place. So that lightning take place, so initially streamer being by the pilot leader which conduct the accumulated charges. Okay, so we have seen that the lightning occur in a monsoon season, and we see that very beautiful picture of the lightning. And we all think that this is the forward stroke is going. I think something is coming from cloud to earth. Yeah, but it is generally the backstroke, not the forward stroke. Let me just tell you how it is. Initial streamer begin by the pilot leader, which conduct the accumulated charges. The pilot leader continues to come down until the potential gradient of the tip is maintained. So this is nothing but the pilot leader. Okay. Now this will be maintained until the potential gradient of the tip is maintained. So potential gradient should be maintained. If it is not maintained, then the leader cannot be transferred toward the ground. So the mandatory condition is the pilot leader, the potential gradient of the tip should be maintained. Okay. Now this will take many branches. As you can see, I have shown the 1 branches, 2 branches, and 3 branches. But as it go towards the earth, it will divide it into more branches. They're shown in the next figure. Okay. So when pilot leader reaches to the earth, there is increase in electrostatic field of the earth. Obviously, and streamer going upward from earth is produced. Okay, so as it is traveled through the pilot leader at the next end, which is earth, now it is going upward from earth, and as we know that our earth is now, it is positively charged, so as a result heavy spark is produced between the earth and crown cloud. This is called the lightning stroke. So it is nothing but hum jo dekh rahe ho kya hai ki negatively charged this pilot leader will be there. Now the positive charge is now neutralize this pilot leader, which is known as a return streamer. Okay, so what we are heavy spark we are seeing by the naked eyes is nothing but a reverse stroke. No, it is not the forward stroke, actually it is a reverse stroke. Why? Because negatively charged this branches are neutralized by this positively charged return streamer, and due to the neutralization there will be a heavy spark which is visibly we can see with our naked eyes, and this is nothing but a lightning stroke that can we visibly see. So what we are seeing is not the forward stroke, it is actually a reverse stroke. Okay, so this is nothing but a formation. What is lightning and how the lightning is produced? Now let us discuss. There are two types of lightning stroke, and the A types of lightning stroke and the B type of lightning stroke. So what is the difference between the lightning stroke? Let's say this is the cloud which is a positively charged, and due to that on the earth there will be a building which is negatively charged. So as we have discussed the theory of lightning, how the lightning stroke is produced, so there will be a lightning stroke between the cloud and the building. So the charges of opposite polarity are induced on the top of the tall building due to the charged clouds, and there will be a lightning stroke between the cloud and building. So this kind of lightning stroke is known as a A type stroke. Then what is a B type stroke? Now here the lightning stroke produced between the cloud A and cloud B. Why? Because the cloud A is positively charged and the cloud B is negatively charged, so these will neutralize each other and there will be some lightning stroke between A to B. Now due to C, the lightning produced on the object or the ground. Now the C is free from A and B. So now due to C, which is positively charged, there will be some negatively charged, whether it is a building or any object on the earth, and there will be flash or between the cloud C and any object. So this kind of lightning stroke is known as a B type lightning stroke. So A is nothing but the lightning stroke between the charged cloud and any object on the earth, and B is lightning kind of lightning stroke which is generally occurs cloud to cloud lightning stroke. Okay, now the at that time the range of current will be some 10 kiloamperes to 90 kiloamperes, and for the period of 1 millionth of the part of the second, 1 millionth part of the second. So as already we have told you that what is transient, transient is nothing but for some instant, or we can say for very short duration, the value of the quantity will become very high. Okay, which is known as transient. So as far as lightning transient is concerned, the current will be 10 kiloampere to 90 kiloampere, and for the period of 1 millionth part of seconds. Okay, this is a very short time, 1 second, 1 millionth part of the second. So it is a very short time. Now let us discuss the static charging offline due to clouds. Okay, so again in future we are going to discuss the traveling wave phenomena, and for that you have to understand this part, how the static charge is generated on a transmission line, what the effect it is going to be doing transmission line. Okay, how traveling wave will travel through the transmission line to the equipment. If it is traveled to the equipment, what damage it can be done. Okay, so all these things will be clear, and so for that you have to understand this topic, and then we are going to discuss traveling wave, and then you are going to discuss the protection needs to be done against this kind of transient in a power system. Okay, so let's say there is a negatively charged cloud is there, so due to this cloud there will be some positively charged on the transmission line. Now due to the wind, with the blow of the wind, the charges on line will not remain bound. So now these charges on the line will not remain bound because due to the wind, the position of cloud is going to be changed. So if it is going in this right direction, the cloud will move in the right direction. Then now the position of these positive charges are not bound at this point only, but they will travel two sides of the line. And magnitude of this traveling wave is around 10 kilovolt to 15 kilovolt, and it has the steep wave front. So already I've discussed it, the wave has steep wave front. The magnitude will be very high, around 10 kV to 15 kV. It damages the insulator and also causes damage to the supports. So ultimately it is going to damage our transmission line, the insulators, the supporting towers. This energy is dissipated through the inductance and resistance of the line when the direct stroke takes place. Okay, so it dangerous when it happens near to the generating station or the substation, because it, as it is traveling, a traveling wave reaches at the end, the steepness of wave front is going to be reduced by, because this is the resistance and inductance will be there in transmission line. Okay, so due to the impedance of a transmission line, the steepness of wave front will be reduced. So effect on the equipments which is at the substation or the generating station will be very less. But if these kind of phenomena occur at the terminal of the substation or the generating station, it will damage our equipments. So protection should be needed. Now these are all are the stuff which is the, let me just remind you, over voltage due to the external causes. Okay, so again, what is over voltage due to external causes? What is the cause of external external causes for transient? It will be lightning. How the lightning is going to be produced? We have seen the phenomena of the lightning. Then we have discussed what are the different types of lightning stroke. In that we have discussed A type lightning stroke and the B type lightning stroke. What is A type lightning stroke? So when the cloud and the earth, there will be lightning stroke between both of them, which is A type of lightning stroke. What is B type of lightning stroke? It is nothing but the intercloud lightning stroke. Okay, then we have discussed the static charge of line due to the clouds. Okay, we have discussed that how our protection scheme needs to be considered. So all these things is for lightning or the external causes of the transient. Now as far as the over voltage or the voltage transient due to internal causes is concerned, so when there is a sudden change in a circuit condition. Okay, so transient, again let me just revise to you what is transient. So when our power system is changes its position from one steady state to another state, there will be transient, there will be production of transient. Either it is a voltage transient and current transient. So when there is a sudden change in a circuit condition, the oscillation are produced due to inductance and the capacitance of the circuit, and in the result they increases the system voltage. Okay, now the amount of voltage is approximately the twice the system voltage. Now as we have discussed in a lightning or the external causes, the amount of voltage increases due to the lightning is very high. Okay, it is around 10 kV to 15 kV, but the amount of voltage increases here is the twice the system voltage. So with compared to the external causes, over voltage due to internal cause is very less. Okay, so as far as the effect of over voltage is concerned, the external causes is very dangerous. As far as internal causes is concerned, it is the value of over voltage is very less. Hence it is not necessary to provide additional protection if the insulation of the equipment is designed properly. So if the insulation of the equipment is properly designed, then we need not to worry about the additional protection. Now let us discuss the switching surges. What is the switching surges? What is the arcing ground and what is the resonance? So we can say that when switching operation is done in a power system, it can be on with load or without load. The voltage produced as a result of this is called the switching surges. So switching surge is nothing but when switching operation is done in a power system. It can be possible on load condition, it can be possible on off load condition. Both this time, the over voltage value of over voltage, or the let's say in this case the peak value will be different. So the let's say EM, the value of EM will be different in both the case. Steepness of wavefront will be different in both the case, with the load or without load. So we are talking about both these things. Okay, so try to understand, when switching operation is done in a power system with or without the load, the voltage produced as a result of this is called the switching surge. So with or without load, that only thing you have to understand. So both the value will be different, so don't confuse between with load and without the load. Now let me just go through both this thing in detail. So switching on and off of the unloaded line. Okay, so when the line is unloaded, now here the only thing you have to worry about is the line is unloaded. What we are going to do, we are switching on and off both of the unloaded line. So at that time, when the line is unloaded, the voltage will be, in short we can say the voltage, let's say there is a switching happens in a power system. Due to that, now the our transmission line is unloaded. So when we are switching on the generating station, we are connecting our transmission line to our generating station where our power system is unloaded. At that time, the voltage surge will generated, and that voltage surge, it travels to the transmission line at the receiving end. Now there is no load is connected, so that traveling voltage wave is come back with the same polarity again at the generating station. So let's say the voltage is first is V. Now without changing the polarity, is come back, so it will be now double V plus V, it will be 2V. So there will be some voltage doubling effect will be there. So as if we are switching on the load or switching on in unloaded condition, then first it will become double the voltage. Let's say if it is V first, then it will become 2V, and then the normal condition, the applied voltage, let's say it is a V, then this will be V voltage. Now in case of switching off, when our, again let me, our transmission line is again, it is unloaded, so when we are turning it off, the first is become double and then zero. Okay, because when we are switching it off, the natural voltage will be V, so it will again traveling at the end, the again polarity will be same, so it will become first 2V, then it will become zero. So this thing we have to understand, the phenomena of traveling wave. Okay, so when we understand the wave propagation, the traveling wave phenomena, the attenuation wave, that all things will be later on we are going to study. So this is important to you, but now try to understand that when we are switching on and off our unloaded transmission line, initially the voltage become double. If we are switching on the load, then it will be double than the normal voltage. If we are switching off, then it will be double first and then zero. Obviously, if we are switching off, then it will be zero at the end. If we are switching on, there will it will be normal at some point. Okay, transient will be some for short duration. Okay, so after that doubling effect, it will be normal. Okay, now this thing will be understandable easy. Now the second is switching on, or we can say off of loaded line. Now as we have discussed first the unloaded line, now we are going to discuss the loaded line. Now suppose a loaded line is switching on. Okay, let's say we are having a transmission line. Now let's say we are going to making it switch on. So the voltage produced will be, as we have discussed earlier, it will be two times the whatever the voltage is, two times Z0 multiplied by I, where Z0 is nothing but our natural impedance of a transmission line, which is depends on the transmission line constant, not on the load. As far as Z0 is concerned, if it is a short transmission line, then we have to consider the effect of resistance and inductance. If it is a medium transmission line, we have to consider the effect of a shunt capacitance. long transmission line, if we are going for the lumped parameter or the distributed parameter, so Z0 is nothing but the natural impedance of the transmission line. Current I is the instantaneous value of the current. Okay, so let's say we are assuming this value. This is not the actual value, but we are assuming that Z0 is, let's say it is 800 ohm and I is 50 ampere. Here it is the RMS value, not the peak value. Here I is the peak value, or we can say instantaneous value. Here I is the different. I have mentioned I and I same, but I is peak value, this in black pen, and here in blue pen it is its RMS value. So don't confuse in between them. So the voltage produced will be two times here. Put the value of Z0 and put the value of I into this equation. There will be 2 times 800 root 2 multiplied by 50. So if you calculate this, it will be 131.1 kV. So it is 131.1 kilovolt. So if the peak value of the voltage is Vm, or let's say that it is Vm kilowatt, then the maximum line voltage will be Vm plus 11. I have made one mistake. It should be 131.1, not 113. 131.1 kilovolt. Okay, so it is understandable, na? Because voltage produced due to switching is 131.1 kV. The natural value of the voltage is Vm. So the total value will be, the maximum line voltage will be Vm plus this much of voltage it is produced. So it is Vm plus 131.1 kV. Just make sure I have made one mistake. It is 131.1 kilowatt. So this is what happening during we are switching on or switching off the loaded transmission line. Okay, so this is the difference between the switching on and off of unloaded transmission line and loaded transmission line. This is what the switching surges. The next thing is current chopping. Now, although you have discussed these things, you are going to study the circuit breakers in high voltage engineering, or you are going to study also in a switch current protection. In that case, the current chopping will be there, and air blast circuit breaker, bus. But as far as we are going to discuss the different part of a power system transient, especially the internal causes, the current chopping will be there. So it is generally happens in air blast circuit breaker. So you don't have to worry about in other cases, in case of a circuit breaker, or you are using a vacuum circuit breaker or air brake circuit breaker, the current chopping generally occurs in a air blast circuit breaker. So now, what is current chopping? So it is nothing but before coming to its natural zero condition, if the value of current is interrupted and becomes zero immediately, the high voltage transient is produced across the contact of the circuit breaker. So before coming to its natural zero condition, if we are trying to make this current zero by anyhow, there will be some high voltage transient will be produced, and that contact of the circuit breaker at the transient is produced across the contact of the circuit breaker, and this phenomena is known as a current chopping. Okay, because we are going to chop the current. Okay, we are generally using this word of chopping. So this chopping is nothing but we are making the current instantaneously zero. We are interrupting the current to make it zero. Naturally it will become zero after some time, but we are making the current zero before its natural zero. So we are interrupting the current. At that time the voltage or the transient will be produced. This kind of effect is known as, this kind of phenomena is known as a current chopping. Now this can be removed by the resistance switching. Okay, now as far as the second thing is concerned, okay, so as we are discussing the over voltage due to internal causes, the first is switching surges. In switching surges we have discussed switching on and off in unloaded line, on and off in loaded line, the current chopping. And the second point of internal cause is arcing ground. Now in short, when neutral is not earth in three phase line. Okay, so what should be, what happen in case of the neutral of three phase line is not earth? and at that time the line to ground fault actually occurs. So this phenomena is known as a arcing ground. Okay, so when neutral is not connected and line to ground fault occurs, only the line to ground, not here it is not mentioned the double line to ground or the triple line to ground, line to line. Here arcing ground, try to understand, is nothing but the neutral is not earth, at that time line to ground fault is occur, is known as a arcing ground. Okay, this briefly we are going to discuss what is arcing ground, but just try to understand the internal causes of a transient. Okay, now due to this, the oscillation of 3 to 4 times the normal magnitude are produced. Okay, so this is the second cause of a transient in a power system. This is the second internal cause. Third internal cause is resonance in a power system. So what is resonance? So when XL is equal to XC, or we can say when our inductive reactance is equal to our capacitive reactance, or we can say inductive reactance minus capacitive reactance is equal to zero, that condition is known as a resonance. And at the time of the resonance, as we can say our transmission line impedance Z is equal to R square plus XL minus XC whole square. Now as XL minus XC, I am talking about the series resonance, that is why XL minus XC, if it is equal to zero, or we can say XL is equal to XC, at that time transmission line impedance Z will be equal to R only, and we can say that R become minimum because Z is equal to under root R square plus XL minus XC whole square. Now XL minus XC is equal to zero, so obviously the Z will be minimum. If R plus something will be more value than R, okay, if I am adding something in R, the value of Z will be more. Now if it is only R, in that case the value of Z will be minimum. So at the time of the resonance, due to XL is equal to XC and the second term becomes zero, that is why we can say the Z is equal to R and Z become minimum. Now ask yourself, what will be the value of current at the time of resonance? Obviously if Z is equal to R and Z become minimum, and in a circuit Z become minimum, it means the current become maximum. So XL is equal to XC is not possible at power frequency. So such kind of condition will never occur in a power system at power frequency, which is 50 Hertz. But if distortion occur in a waveform of the EMF, the value of XL and XC become equal at some frequency, let's say the fifth or the multiple harmonics, and this may result into the resonance. Okay, so due to this, the overvoltage are produced. Okay, so these are the three internal causes in a power system which produce the overvoltage or the transient. The first one is switching surges, the current, the second one is arcing ground, and the resonance. Okay, so up till now we have discussed what is the power system transient, what is the voltage source, what is the different definitions, like what is crest value, what is rise time, what is the wave front, what is wave tail. Okay, all these things we have studied to understand the voltage waveform or the current waveform. Then we have discussed the different causes of the overvoltage in a power system. Then we have discussed the overvoltage due to external causes, and that we have discussed the, how the lightning is going to be produced, different types of lightning stroke, type A, type B. Also we have discussed the phenomena of traveling wave on a transmission line. After that we have discussed the overvoltage due to the internal causes. Okay, in internal causes we have discussed the switching surges, the arcing ground, and the resonance. Okay, so thank you students. After that we are going to study the transient in a AC circuit and transient in a DC circuit. After completing AC DC circuits transient, we are going to understand the wave, traveling wave, or we can say the different types of wave propagation in the transmission line. If our circuit is a short, if our circuit is open circuited, short circuited, it is connected with some kind of load. Okay, so all these things will be there in the next session. Thank you. Now I'm going to